The health of honeybees is a concern for everybody, especially honeybee scientists like me. We are constantly looking for ways to help honeybees and beekeepers. Why have honeybees suffered in the last decades? That's the question many other honeybee scientists ask themselves daily. We learned a lot in the last 2 decades and continue learning new things today. I was reading last week when I found a USDA researcher showing something very interesting that, if it's true, it could help a lot of beekeepers out there. Since 1980s, there has been a dramatic decrease in the number of acres of sunflower planted in the United States. The researcher, my colleague Dr. Evan Palmer Young, also looked at APHIS database and found another interesting correlation. Apiary exposed to more sunflower fields had lower varroa mite levels for some reason. Varroa mites are the number one enemy of honeybees for a reason. All over the world, honeybees are dying because of this parasite. If you're new to bees, varroa mite feed primarily in the fat bodies of honeybees, transmitting terrible viruses that ultimately kill them. It is a nasty parasite. So the researchers start to be suspicious of the correlation observed, but they are also aware that correlation does not equal causation. For example, if you compare the number of ice cream sales with the number of shark attacks, the two variables strongly correlate. Does this mean that consuming ice cream causes shark attacks? Of course not. The more likely explanation is that more people consume ice creams and get in the ocean when it's warmer outside, which explain why these two variables are so highly correlated. That's the challenge for the researchers here, to find data that shows that the correlation is not random. Hi there, before we continue this video, I have to talk to you about the sponsor of this video, Vita Bee Health. Vita Bee Health is the largest company dedicated to honeybee health. Without Vita, many of the products, registered products we have in the market today, wouldn't be available to all of us. Vita have helped many beekeepers and bees all over the world, and I'm very grateful to have Vita sponsoring my videos. Please check them out using the link in the description, and let's go back to the video. So it is clear the correlation between sunflower and varroa mite levels exists. However, there is any other data supporting the idea that the two are connected. Can sunflowers somehow help honeybees to fight varroa mites? That's the question we need an answer to. The first hypothesis that comes to mind is nutrition. Perhaps sunflower nectar and pollen are unique somehow, and the bees get stronger to fight varroa mites. That could explain the correlation observed. However, sunflowers is already known to be generally not considered a good resource for honeybees. Like many other plants from the Asteraceae family, that includes a bunch of important plants, sunflower pollen is low in protein compared with other bee-visited plants. And experiments using exclusively sunflower-based diets do not support the development of honeybees and bumblebees. This has led to the conclusion that the potential nutrition role of sunflower was unlikely to explain the correlation. How could sunflower be helping the honeybees then? Is there any data that could make the case stronger? The second hypothesis was medication. Yes, the sunflower might not be a good nutrition source for honeybees, but it might be acting as a medicine. I'll not be surprised by that idea. Along evolution, for sure, honeybees have learned how to take advantage of many different plants to improve their own health. Several studies have demonstrated the benefits of nectar and pollen from sunflowers and other plants from the Asteraceae family for resistance to parasites. For example, Asteraceae pollen provisions were associated with resistance to brood parasite in mason bees. That's interesting. Another interesting fact is that, in another study, sunflower and goldenrod pollen promotes gut infection resistance in bumblebees. And in honeybees, consuming sunflower pollen and honey can reduce infection by the gut microsporidium parasite Nosema serrana, another terrible honeybee parasite. And most interesting of all, honeybees infected with Nosema serrani apparently search for sunflower honey when multiple options of honey are available, showing a potential indication of self-medication behavior. This is getting better and better, and why not to put that to a test? And that was precisely what the researcher did. They fed honeybee colonies in the field with supplementation rich in sunflower pollen and compared the varroa mite levels with honeybees fed with other pollen sources. And apparently, as you can see in this graph, when you feed bees with sunflower pollen, the varroa mite levels are kept under the treatment threshold. That is encouraging. The beekeeping industry desperately needs something new to fight varroa mite because many of the products in the market today are failing. This is exciting, but we need to be very cautious here. Every new scientific discovery must be confirmed and reconfirmed independently by other researchers, especially in the honeybee research field, working with a wild animal where there are so many variables that we as scientists cannot control. If the results of this research are correct, and in fact sunflowers protect bees against varroa mites, it is fair to say that sunflowers work secretly protecting all of us. We need more research in that direction, using potential solutions from Mother Nature to help us all. I interviewed Dr. Evan Palmer Young on my podcast if you want more details about the project and future directions of this intriguing research. Link in the description. Also, if you are a Patreon of this channel, you have already received the ad-free video version of this podcast, and I want to take the opportunity here to thank you all for your support. If you like videos like this, I encourage you to subscribe to the channel and watch this video right here to learn more about the teachings of the most successful society in natural history, the honeybees. It is great to have you here. Thanks for watching Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.